It's Tox from CritsHappen.com. Thanks for watching and welcome back. Today we are here with a critical strike, where we take a game that we've been playing recently, run it through its paces very quickly, and let you know about our experiences while playing it. Now we've talked about some pretty fun things on this show, from dinosaur wizards to ninja zombies, but today we're going to talk about a kid's game called Robot Turtles. Now, Robot Turtles is from a company called Think Fun, and most of you may know it because it was an extremely popular Kickstarter. This is a game that claims to be able to teach programming to young children, as young as 4 years old. And as you can tell, the box is very cartoony and has that kid-like appeal. Now, I've already even seen this on the shelves at Target, which means it's getting some real big mass appeal, which is really cool. The question is, can it really take programming and teach it to that young of a child? Most of us who are gamers are used to games like Robot Arena or Volt or Lords of Exodid or things like that that have programming that are very, very advanced programming type features. So programming can be advanced, but it can be pretty basic, pardon the pun. So let's check it out. Let's grab our shells, let's grab our gems, and jump into the world of Robot Turtles. So Robot Turtles claims to be able to teach children programming, but how does it do that? Well, very simply, each kid is going to have a turtle, and you'll see it's got this really nice gold fleck painting on it, which is really cool and shiny. You'll notice around the turtle there is a sunflower, there is like a purple tulip, and a blue dandelion. And I'm probably slaughtering the types of flower those are because I'm not a botanist, but that's the way it goes. But those are on there for a very specific reason. We'll show you in a second why. The object is for the child to play cards and get their turtle from where they start to where their gem is. Now, that sounds really simple, right? And it should be at the very beginning. But as you'll see, things are going to get a little more complicated. So for example, as a child, I might say, well, I want my turtle to go forward. So I would play a card that goes forward. Now, when you move, the child doesn't move. The player or the adult or the teacher, whoever it is that's coordinating the game, is actually suggested to do the movement for the child. The child is the programmer and the adult is the one that's going to execute the program. So you may be able to do something wild and wonky like you could do whatever kind of crazy noises you want to do. It's always recommended, obviously, when you're playing with kids to get as funny and as silly and as crazy as you want. So you're going to move them forward one. Now, the child may then say, well, I want to turn left. So this is going to rotate the turtle to the left. Now, you'll notice when they rotate, the colors match the flowers that they are pointing towards. So this not only tells the child that they're turning left, but it also starts to get the visual recognition of the color yellow, the yellow flower, that's going to turn my character this way. The same thing goes with turning right. You now have the purple, so it turns it to the right. So you could, as a child, play several forward cards to get your turtle to go forward, and then a left card to go left, and then several more forward cards to connect to your jewel and be able to win the game or beat that puzzle. Now, that sounds really easy because in something like this, you're just going forward and turning left. And for young kids, that is great. It teaches them exactly what they need to know. But you may have noticed that I had a bunch of different cards, like green and red cards, in my hand. So let's talk a little bit about what you would use those for. You'll see here over on the right, there are three different types of obstacles that can get added to the game. You have ice towers, stone towers, and boxes or crates. These go on the board just like anything else, and they can become obstacles. And what happens now is there's different ways to interact with the obstacles. So as the children learn the basics of the programming and function cards, they can now start to add special cards in. The first special card they can add is lasers. Now lasers, you'll see, melt ice. And again, it's that visual aid of teaching children exactly what it does. So if I were to move up my here, rotate my turtle, move up and rotate my turtle, if I moved up again, I'm now stuck between a stone wall, which is completely immovable and undestroyable. We have a box which can be pushed. So if I came up from this end, I could push the box up like this. But now I'm stuck with this ice wall in my way. Well, this is when you teach the children, remember, that lasers melt ice. So they could play this and it would melt this and turn it into a pool of water, which they could then, as a turtle, cross over and get to their gem. So there becomes more advanced complexes or more advanced pieces that you can add in. Now, even more so, you could get to a position where you could have programming functions. Let's say, for example, that I wanted to make a more advanced string with my character, and I wanted to say, go forward, and go left. And every time I wanted to do that, I make it my function. That's what the green frog is for. So what that means is, as I play green frogs, it will always go forward, forward, left. So in this case, I would go forward, forward, and turn left if I played that function frog. So you can start to teach more advanced programming features to children as well. And all of that comes together quite nicely because you can string out multiple different things for kids. Now you may say to yourself, well, as you get more advanced, what if they make a mistake? Well, that's what the bug card is for. The bug sits right near the player, and if they make a mistake, they're allowed to hit that and go bug, and they rewind, and they go back to before they made their move, which is kind of a mulligan or a do-over. The beauty about Robot Turtles is it's flexible. It is so flexible for you to be able to use with a young child and teach them basics, with a more advanced child and teach them intermediary things, and with a really advanced programming student and be able to teach them even more complicated puzzles and concepts. There are a lot of different things in the book that are suggested setups for the game or suggested puzzles for the game, but you, using your own imagination, can come up with a ton because you get a bunch extra of these stone towers, these ice towers, and these boxes. Now, the boxes can't be moved off. If I'm over here and I go like this, I can't move them off, and the towers can't be destroyed or moved at all. So there's a lot of different interactive puzzles that you can put together for your little programmers to understand, to learn from, and to grow from. And that's probably the biggest thing inside of Robot Turtles, is you grow. As you start learning the concepts as a player, you start to grow and learn more advanced concepts, make it more complex, make it more involved, and quite frankly, make it want to hit the table more. So if you have young children, if you're a teacher, this game is something that should definitely be on your radar.
So I love it when a game actually delivers on what it says it's going to deliver on. And Robot Turtles does that. There's no surprise to me whatsoever that this is on the shelves at Target. In fact, it's more of a surprise, it's not on the shelves everywhere. This game is probably one of the best, if not the best, teaching aids / parental games you could get for you and your kids to enjoy. My youngest is 6, that's Wyatt. My older boy is 9, that's Zach. Zach is a much more advanced gamer. He likes playing things like Lords of Exodus, Lords of Waterdeep. He likes some good strategy games. Both of them got this game really quick and really easy. But to give you an idea, that because Zach is so advanced in his gaming, he was already coming up with puzzles. And that's one of the cool things that I really like about Robot Turtles, is that while it seems on the surface almost too basic, it seems as though from a parent's side you might get bored with it pretty quickly, even though the children are learning and getting their skills down and understanding all the concepts in the game. Zach was immediately finding ways to put puzzles together to play with his brother, which I thought was really, really cool. The same thing happens with adults. You can start to see, okay, as my child develops, as they start to learn different skills and different concepts of combinations, you can start to put together different puzzles, which is really cool. The whole idea of having the walls and the ice walls was a really good idea. You have the boxes. You actually can come up with your own concepts. I mean, we came up with our own and put them into the game as well. There's a lot of little things that they do that's really well, like the gold foil printing. The gold foil around the outside of the bug, on the outside of the turtle, and on the outside of the gym is really smart. I mean, children are just naturally attracted to things that are shiny. They want to be able to learn about them. They want to, they're just curious. It's a kid, right? The cards are really basic, but the artwork, the artwork is really good. It's something that a kid, again, can latch onto, can capture really quickly, visually process, and get moving with everything. The bug idea was actually really smart, going, you know, being able to do an undo or a mulligan or whatever you want to call it. They did really good with that. The gameplay is simple, right? You're playing cards, you're moving your turtles, but it's about the interaction. It's about the learning experience. It's about, for me, the capability to sit down with my children and teach them things and then see them grow those skills even in just one game setting. The first time we sat down to play, I sat down with my 6-year-old, taught him exactly what everything did in a basic game, and he was off and running, and he's only six. So he was picking it up, he was understanding what to do, and we were immediately jumping into the blocks, we were immediately jumping into the ice walls, and things like that. So it was really cool to see the basics sink in, and then the growth just in that one session. But then, like I said, from there, the boys started playing on their own, and they started making puzzles for each other to play, and puzzles for each other to kind of accomplish, or mazes, so to speak, to get through, and that was really cool as well. There's a ton of replayability inside of Robot Turtles, and even more so, if you're a teacher, this is a game that I think just belongs on your shelf. For example, my oldest went through speech therapy when he was younger, and the teacher would use board games to help them talk and help them move through and read and do things like that. This is a game that engages you, because as the parent, you're there moving, or as the teacher, you're there moving the turtles for them. There's engagement automatically between the player and kind of the coordinator, I guess you would call it. So this is a game that I could easily see sitting on any teacher's shelf, on any special needs teacher's shelf, on any, you know, therapy teacher type shelf. It's just a great way to engage kids and immediately get them started. And that's what I really loved about Robot Turtles. Now, truth be told, for gamers, for guys that are my age, like if I wanted myself and my game group to get together and play, we're probably not going to play this game. We'd probably house rule a ton of stuff to make it like over the top crazy, but we're probably not going to play this game. This is really designed to be exactly what it explains itself to be. It's a game to teach children programming. So if you're a parent of young gamers, if you have really young gamers, they're not kidding when they're talking about 4 years old. I've seen three-year-olds play this game and still pick it up. If you are looking for a game to get your younger kids into gaming, this is a really great start. If you're a teacher, I highly suggest it. And at the end of the day, it is a game that is very well produced. It is extremely well put together and does exactly what it says it's going to do. It's going to teach children how to understand programming skills and how to develop those skills. So overall, I've been extremely happy with Robot Turtles. But let us know what you think. Do you have children, and what games do you use to teach them skills? Have you gotten this, and are your kids enjoying Robot Turtles as well? Let us know. Leave your comments below on the YouTube channel. Of course, you can chime in on Facebook and Twitter by searching Crits Happen, or at our homepage at critshappen.com. Until we see you next time, we hope you enjoy all your gem-chasing times inside the world of Robot Turtles. Thanks so much for watching. Keep rolling those dice, and we hope they're all crits.